I became first interested in an inkling of interest in medicine when I myself was a patient at probably the age of 12, 13. And had to have emergency surgery, and I fell in love with my doctors and my nurses. I went to medical school at Columbia called the College of Physicians and Surgeons. It's an ancient and honorable name. But I was one of, the class was 120 and there were 10 women. I did research from day one in medical school, and that just sealed my fate.
When I first met Dr. Donahoe, it was 47 years ago. Pat Donahoe came to see me with the chief of pediatric surgery to see whether I would give her an appointment as a research fellow. I enjoyed meeting her very much. I thought she was extremely intelligent, very passionate about what she wanted to do, very self-directed in terms of getting the job done. She turned out to be an excellent surgeon, a fantastically wonderful scientist, and actually a really great leader.
I met Dr. Donahoe in 1993. I had just finished medical school and I started my surgical residency here at MGH. She's a terrific mentor. I would say that's the, you know, that if there's anything that I can accomplish as I get further along in my career is to make that the primary goal. She puts you under her wing and she has introduced me to people in the field of pediatric surgery, helped me with writing grants, getting into societies in surgery, and so making those connections is invaluable.
I first met Pat when I was just starting my own career as a junior faculty member in neurology at the Mass General Hospital. In that role, I tended to work extremely late at night and long hours on weekends, and almost inevitably at the end of the evening, as I was getting on the elevator to go home, I would bump into this amazing surgeon who was working equally hard, Dr. Donahoe, who gave me advice, counsel, friendship, and rallied the troops around these long hours for the purpose of academic research in medicine.
I would have to say that Pat Donahoe is really a phenomenon because she is so incredibly determined and so passionate about her work. No hurdle is too high for her to work on, and she has surmounted many hurdles to do some really, really outstanding science that will last, I think, for probably ever.
This is somebody who was the first female surgical resident in Boston, the first female professor of surgery at Harvard. And I think that says a lot about who she is.
She's legendary primarily because she's been a phenomenal clinician scientist who has herself done great work, but who has also mentored and brought along probably two generations now of clinician scientists behind her.
I think it's a privilege of a lifetime, and I really very, very much appreciate it. I know that there are thousands of people out there who are more worthy than I am, so I consider it a great privilege and a great honor.